Beautiful souls, witches, thank you so much for joining me for this new video. Today I do a review of the Witches World Oracle deck created by the beautiful Natalie Needham. So welcome aboard. Witches, I'm very happy to be with you today through this video. And first, before I start anything, I'm gonna just light my sage, because I really need smoke right now. It's gonna be awesome to do this video with the smell of the sage. I don't know why it's kind of hard to, you know, light it at the moment. I think it's like maybe humid in my office right now. Yeah, that should work. So thank you so much for joining me. I'm so happy to share this moment with you. I'm sending you smoke. Yeah, we need clarity right now. We need to purify ourselves. So let's do that together. Okay, I'm here now. So before I start anything, I just need to talk to you about something. I'm gonna share with you a little story about this deck, okay? So I pre-ordered this deck a long time ago. I think it was last year, in probably in October or something. And this deck was shipped to me in January 2020, just right after the holidays. And February came and no deck, and March came, no deck. So I was kind of worried. I called the creator and, you know, we exchanged a few emails. And as the deck never showed up, you know, we were very disappointed, but we thought it was lost. So yeah, I was very disappointed, but Natalie was very nice to me. She was very kind. She was a sweetheart. So hi, Natalie. And sometimes it can happen. And there was the coronavirus thing and the mail was slow and everything. So I was like, okay, well, I will never get this deck probably. And, you know. And a few days ago, I went to my mailbox and there was a package inside. So first I thought it was a deck I won on Instagram, but this deck was coming from England. And this one, the Witch's World Oracle deck, was coming from Canada. So I saw the sticker on the box. It was Mindful Magic. So I immediately understand that it was my witchy deck, and I was so all over the moon. I mean, I was so excited. So before I opened the package, I saw that you know, the stick, like not the sticker, but paper for the custom had been ripped off. And another thing was a stick onto the box, and you know, there was paper inside the plastic thing. So I just, you know, had a look at the papers, and I saw that my deck was wrongly routed first, you know, from Canada, from British Columbia. It had been routed to Australia, to Melbourne, instead of my country, France. And I mean, that's so weird, you know, because my deck traveled all the way from Canada to Australia and then went back all the way to France and came to me. So yeah, I really thought it was incredible, because there was no tracking number on the package, so it could have been lost, obviously. And I was so happy to receive it. And you know, the weirdest part is that I have a very dear friend of mine in Australia, and he lives in Melbourne. And when I told him about that, he was like, "What? All the cities in the world and your deck went to my city? I mean, you know, that's crazy." And yeah, so my friend Lucas, if you're watching this video, hello, I hope you're doing okay. I'm sending you lots of good vibes at the moment and much love. And yeah, so that's a crazy story, but I finally got this deck and I'm so happy. So now let's jump into it, guys. So it came with a beautiful business card. So it says Mindful Magic. She has an Etsy shop, so I'm gonna put her links down below, her Etsy shop and also her Instagram if you want to follow her on the social media. I also got a candle because when I pre-ordered the deck, I also ordered a candle. And it's a very, very, very interesting candle. It smells so good, guys. I love the glitter. I love the color. It's very earthy, very witchy. It smells like a witch forest. I just love it so much. So you got rosemary and orange peel and frankincense, and it smells so fucking good. I mean, yeah, I just love it. So I'm gonna use it tonight. I was supposed to use it a couple of days ago, and then, you know, I just forgot to bring it upstairs with me. So tonight I'm gonna do a ritual, and I'm gonna use this candle because it's very earthy. And as you guys know, I'm very close to nature, to fauna and flora, and I think it's gonna help me in my ritual tonight. So yeah, let's talk about the deck now. So it comes also with a flyer. So it's a thank you note. You have the Etsy shop right here. And you have five card spread over here. So very interesting. I'm gonna try this. I haven't tried it yet. Unleash the magic within spread. So there is no spread in the guidebook, only this one, but you can use any kind of spread you like to use. So yeah, I'm gonna try that later on. And this is the deck, guys. The Witch's World Oracle deck. So it comes in a very nice box, a black box, and it's very, very sturdy. There is a quote on the back of the box. The world is full of magic things, patiently waiting for our senses to grow sharper. And it's by W.B. Yeats. Yeats, I hope I'm pronouncing the name right. So yeah, very nice, created by Natalie Needham, as I told you before, and the artwork is by Victoria Victoria Ramanovich. So it's very, very, very nice deck. So inside it's black, regular, you know, and the deck and the guidebook. So first, before showing you the cards, I'm gonna show you the guidebook. So the deck is divided in several categories. You'll see that. So here you have a little word by Natalie. So Natalie wrote the guidebook and Victoria did the artwork. It's she did a beautiful job. Both of them did. The illustrations are watercolors, and they're so beautiful. So first you have the witch tools. Every time on each for each card you have the name of the card, a keyword, a main keyword, and then you have keywords, a few ones, an explanation, and questions. So if you're journaling, if you like to work with a journal when you do spreads for yourself, it's very interesting because you can dig deeper, and when you answer the questions, you can do a deeper work on yourself. So this is very interesting. So it's the same for all the cards. Then you have plants and flowers. Elements, the four elements, moon phases, stones, and animals. So yeah, this is just absolutely great. At the end of the video, I'm gonna pick a card and read what's in the guidebook for you guys. Okay, so the guidebook is nice. If you're a witch, you're gonna get it. If you're not, you're gonna learn things in the guidebook. So this is the backing of the cards with a beautiful moth, crystals, moon. So usually, I'm gonna be honest with you guys, I don't like when there is a name on the back of the card, okay? But for this one, it doesn't bother me. I think it's pretty nice. I like the writing, so yeah, it doesn't bother me at all. And you know, it goes pretty well with the illustration and everything, so it's nice. I did the ages myself. It's a dark gray. If I remember well, I use a pro marker, and the color, the exact color, is gray, cool gray, number 5, in case you want to do the same thing. So yeah, I just wanted to do the ages so that the deck is mine, you know, it's different, and yeah, now it's my deck. It's unique. So let's see the card. I'm gonna start with the moon phases, then I'll go through the elements, the witch tools, stones, plants, and animals. Okay, so first there is waning moon, recover. So what I like, first, I'm in love with the artwork. And I like that there is a name on each card and a main keyword. So that's nice, because you can work only with your intuition with this deck. And then you can compare what's in the guidebook if you like, and do a deeper work. You know, you can dig deeper with the guidebook and the explanations in the guidebook. But I think it's nice maybe to start working with your intuition first. So waning moon, recover. Full moon, harvest. Beautiful full moon. Waxing moon, growth. New moon, begin. So they were not in order. Then we have the four elements. So each element has a different color. Earth, physical. It's kind of a greenish color, and it's very earthy. Fire, spirit, brown orange color. Air, conscious. It's kind of a bluish gray, very beautiful. Water, emotions, blue. I don't know if you can see it right, but it's very beautiful. And then the witch tools. So Athame, detached. So Athame is a dagger, and it's used for energetic work. So energy work, energetic work, whatever. I think you understand what I want to say. It's used to direct energy in a direction, to draw magic symbols around you and cut energetic bonds that you no longer need, and to clear space around you as well. And it's connected to a masculine energy. Cauldron, which is connected to the feminine energy. It's like a vessel, and it represents the womb of a woman. So yeah, it's a very, very feminine book, knowledge. Pendulum, this pendulum is very beautiful. It kind of look like one of mine. And I like the purple color. The colors are beautiful. I really love it. Really like the touch of color on each card. Pendulum, decision, key, opportunities. Let's open the door, guys. Let's see what's behind the door. Broom, cleanse. Mirror, clarity. This is a beautiful mirror. Wand, control. I like that. Candle, illuminate. Bell, communicate. The bell can be used for healing, but it's also used for, you know, to start a ritual and to finish a ritual. You can ring the bell before you start and ring the bell when you're done. But it's also used to clarify space and cleanse people energy, and you can do cleansing in a room, or you know, yeah, it's kind of like the tinctures and also Tibetan bowl a little bit, so you can use it in different ways. And then we have the stones, guys. Beautiful, beautiful. I'm sorry if I move my phone. Okay, I be careful. Amethyst, balance. It's one of my favorite stones. Pyrite, success. Carnelian, motivate. I call it the happy stone. Moonstone, sacred. Citrine, happiness. I love citrine. Clear quartz, heal. Black tourmaline, eliminate. Rose quartz. Smoky quartz. Ooh, this one is very beautiful. I like that. Celestite, connect. And I miss obsidian and onyx. But you know, I love all the stones anyways, so yeah, because onyx and obsidian are some of my favorite stones too, so that's okay. Flowers and plants, carnation, strength, beautiful, lovely colors. Vibrant colors for the rose, timeless. I love roses. That's my favorite flower. Very beautiful. Stunning. Borage for courage. Willow, flexibility. Gardenia, uplift. Iris, align. I love iris. I love that color. Very beautiful purple. Lavender, serenity. Where I live in south of France, there is lots of lavender everywhere and it smells so good. I like lavender. It's a very nice plant, you know. When it's dry, we put it in a little bag or something. And we put that in the drawers and stuff, and it smells good. And we also use it to sleep better. Lavender is a plant that calms yourself, so I like that. I like the essential oil. I use it a lot. Very good. And it keeps mosquitoes away too. We have a lot of mosquitoes here in the summer. Rosemary, focus. I love rosemary. Mint, refresh. Basil, luck. Rabbit, observe. Very beautiful rabbit. It's cute. Rat, persist. Beautiful as well. Bat, journey. Crow Destiny. I love the colors on this one. Look at that. This is a beautiful crow. Moth Transformation. And this card is my favorite card in the deck. I mean, when I saw this moth, I was like, oh my God, so beautiful. It looks real. It looks like it's gonna come out the card, you know, and it's just gorgeous. Black cat, independence. Look at that cat. Look at those eyes, green eyes. Toad, adapt. Snake, eternity. I love the snake card. Amazing. Spider, create. This one is beautiful too. Look at that spider. Oh my God. With all those colors, like orange, white, black. She's amazing. Or he is. Maybe it's a guy. I don't know. All wisdom, very beautiful. I love owls. I have owl. She comes every day, every night, and I can hear her singing, and yeah, it's nice. Or he, it can be a guy too. I have no idea. So yeah, you saw all the cards, guys. So yeah, this deck is just beautiful. And now I'm gonna shuffle it. And it shuffles pretty well. As you can hear, we can hear a little music. And it's because the cardstock is linen. I don't know if you can see it, but yeah, it's linen. So I like it. I like the paper stock. It's very nice. It's a good paper stock and very good quality. Very good. So you can shuffle the cards, you know, like you shuffle cards. I don't know which way you want to shuffle them. You can also use poker style because they're thick but not too thick. They're just, you know, that's the perfect card stock for me. I don't know, it's maybe 330 or something. Yeah, I think it's 330. I'm not sure about that, but I think so. And that's the perfect cardstock. So we're gonna cut. And what's the message for us today? For all of us, guys. No, not this one. This one. Air, conscious. Okay. Oh my God, I'm so into my mental, you know, reflections and everything right now. I bet we all are, you know, because of the lockdown and everything. So let's see what's in the guidebook, you guys, so that you can have an idea of what's inside the guidebook. I'm gonna put the cards right here. So okay, I'm gonna try to. Oh my God. Yeah, that's good. I opened the book on the right page. Conscious. So you have a few keywords. Transparent, wind, fly, communication, mind, transformation. The air element is closely associated with the mind, thought, intuition, and change. The air itself is ever moving, evolving, and offers a power that cannot be seen but deeply felt. Air is asking you to trust yourself. Your intuition is telling you something that you should not be ignored. Your mind is focused on something. Take a deeper look at it. The wind is blowing. It's time to adjust yourselves to work with it and propel yourself forward. That's a good message. Ask yourself, what is it you already know? What is your conscious mind telling you is the truth? So, yeah, I'm gonna ask that to myself. This is a good deck for, oops, shadow work, also, I think. Yeah, introspection, shadow work, and things like that. So, this is a awesome message, you
So, I
guys.
think I'm done for now.
I hope you guys enjoyed this video, that you like this deck. And if you're not subscribed to the channel, well, you can do it right now. And don't forget to activate the little bell if you want to know when I post a video on my channel. So you can be the first to watch my videos. And if you like it, well, thumbs up. And you can also share this video if you like the content. Thank you so much for being here. And take care of yourself. It's very important at the moment. Take care of yourself. Take care of your loved ones. And I wish you beautiful things. And I see you in another video. Bye, guys.